CBS Radio, good old CBS. The Munsters was on CBS Thursday nights, 1964 and 1965 at 7:30. Nice digs. Host three screenings of Munster Go Home, our feature film at the Redford Theater.
All right, and when is that going to be playing, Butch?
It'll be this Friday night, I believe it's October 21st, and Saturday, October 22nd, three screenings. Friday night, doors open at 7, screenings begins at 8. Saturday matinee, doors open at 1, screening at 2. And Saturday night, doors open at 7 again, and a screening at 8.
Right, and you're going to be there personally for anybody that comes down, right?
I am going to be there personally. I'm going to be meeting and greeting people, setting up the movie. I think that we'll have a Q&A. We're going to be Ustreaming it. A lot of people from Facebook will be coming out, and all the social media people, as well as the old school people who enjoy the old theaters like I do.
That's right. And of course, I don't know too many people who did not watch The Munsters. I really don't.
I think it was an acceptable lifestyle back then. And you either got educated to get out of that lifestyle, or it enveloped you and you became part of that lifestyle. So you're either part of the situation, problem, or part of the solution. For me, it was 41 years, and the gentleman in Oasis that took me in, the only reason he took me in was because I had never been in the celebrity rehab merry-go-round. And he says, if I can fix you, you can get out and you can help a lot of people, because The Munsters is a beloved show and you're a beloved character. And his father happened to be a fan of the show, is why he took me in.
Yeah, doesn't that work?
It really worked.
It really
like right now, we're Ustreaming and Facebooking and tweeting this entire tour, but at least I was on the train. Because I couldn't fly, I had some cancer that was removed, so I had my medical things have been taken care of. I'm reentering the business, I'm sober and clean, and life is good, so I'm really having a great time helping people, because that helps me.
Yes. Well, we're glad to see you. I shouldn't say see you, because our listeners can't see you, but I can see you, and I'll tell you all that's listening. He looks just like Eddie Munster. He hasn't changed a bit, so that's the cool part.
I tell people my receding hairline is now normal.
Well, see, pull a hat back down. I didn't even know that. Yeah, so thank you so much. I really appreciate you coming out.
Thank you, Crystal.
All right.
That's Eddie.
Yeah, about 47 years after the fact.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Does he still look the same though?
Yeah, he does. He really does.
This is Vicki Thomas, our star reporter.
Hey, star reporter.
Violet, yep. Our star writer editor.
This is the star.
Yeah,
the octagon.
They put all the V's over here. Vicki, Violet, that's Vincent.
Yes.
Yeah, the email queen. The queen of email.
That's right.
Gotta get your attention. Thanks, Sandra.
And this is our webmaster, and I think she wants to get a picture for the website.
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
Does anyone have a camera?
Yeah, we're actually right here.
Oh, we'll take it with Crystal.
Okay. I get another one?
I want one too.
Okay.
Well, you guys can.
Hi, Hen.
We'll fight over you. Hi, I'm Zara. Nice to meet you.
Hi, Zara. Pleasure.
I'll take
the
picture here.
I'll take it.
Take a picture.
Yes,
take another
one.
All of us will take
that.
She looks so pretty
and
red. Oh,
thank you.
All right.
That's my sister.
I'm not good enough an actor to pay the rent,
but
it's fucking
healthcare.
All right.
But he's
fine.
Just do it
for fun.
All right. Yeah. I'm going to get my little camera.
One, two.
Blue Shield Association.
Thank you.
And would you like to get
a WWJ News Time? 25 and the update of your money from the suburban Cadillac Buick business desk. Frank Cipolla of the Wall Street Journal. All of a sudden, here the market's taking a plunge today.
Brain's
nice. Very good. I understand you're going to be at the Redford Theater this
Friday night, Saturday night, and Saturday matinee. Three screenings.
You're going to be at Saturday matinee? Because I'm going to try to make it. I got a show this weekend. But have you checked that out?
top to bottom is awesome.
Yeah, I love that place. We go there quite a bit.
It's the best.
They have Three Stooges Festival there, and Laurel and Hardy, and Marx Brothers.
I don't know if they got it all.
Fantastic place. They've still got, you know, the old original organ comes out of the floor.
Top to bottom.
Okay, take care.
$23 a share, now at $22.
Thanks, guys.
It's being made mainly. They'll kill me. I have
you know, these guys get a few awards, don't you think?
Just a few. Just a few. This is actually the oldest station in Detroit.
Wow, that went well. Crystal, she really had her research down, asked good questions, very fast and efficient. Well, this whole trip in Detroit, everybody's been very efficient. That's good. It's a good way of doing business. So, went well. They're going to follow us all the way to Richmond. They want us to send them back footage of us trick-or-treating on Halloween night itself, which ought to be fun. Catch some people at the front door. We're kind of just making it up as we go, but so far so good. We'll get the footage out to you ASAP as we get back to the hotel.